So here's my solution to the programming assignment where I asked you to program an online version of online slam. Let me run it and compare it to the offline slam. When I run it, I get random landmarks and a random initial robot pose. My offline solution gives me this long path over here and estimated landmarks. And the remarkable thing here is that my online version that I coded gives me the same final pose and the same landmarks without retaining this huge matrix for the path before. So how did I do this? Here's my online slam routine. In large parts, it looks exactly like my offline slam routine. I do it in 2D. I have a measurement and motion step. Here's my measurement update. I have to get all these indices right so you can stare at them for a while, but they're all correct here. There's a plus one and minus one over here. And here's the first non-trivial thing. My matrix so far has one robot pose and one entry for each landmark, but now I need to add space for the next robot pose. And the way I do this is I make an expansion list using the expand command. And this expansion list retains the original robot pose, which has coordinates 0 and 1. These are two-dimensional poses. And indices for all the landmarks. So I'm squeezing in two new rows and two new columns for the next robot pose. That's happening in this code over here. With this squeezed in, I can now do the update. The update is being applied exactly at these two new rows and columns that I put in. And here's the math I gave you for factorization applied to this problem, where I go and compute the intermediate matrices A, B, and C that I explained in class. And then I use the take command to kick out the very first row and column, the first two of them, to remove the old robot pose using the exact same logic that I gave you in class. So you can look at this actually implements online slam.